Parrish on piano and keyboard, Mark. Alan Sloan on violin. Rod Morgenstern on drums. Andy West on bass. And Steve Morse, Capricorn Recording Artist, the Dixieland. Thank you.
Thank you. Merci, thank you. All right. Well, let me start off by saying that the Dregs are very proud and honored to be here, and you're a great audience, so it makes it even better for us. This next song we're going to do is one which I think is probably a style that hasn't been covered too much at Montreux, and we're glad to be able to give it to you. This is a thing I like to call avant-garde country music, something sort of unique to us, and it's a thing called patchwork. Thank you. We're going to play it because, like I said earlier, I don't think this kind of music gets displayed too often on the stage of Montreux, and we might as well do it while we're here. This thing is a couple of old country melodies that we stuck together and sped up a little bit, give the guys a chance to pick some on. It's called the Wabash.
Thank you.
playing for you. We've got another tune to do and then we've got to leave, but we just want to say thank you for listening to our music, and what can I say? We'll be back, you know? Thanks. It's a song. This is called Take It Off the Top.
Atlanta, Georgia, the Dixie Dregs. The Dixie Dregs, Steve Hall, Alex Long, Andy West, Rod Morgenstein, and Mark Perry. The Dixie Dregs. Thank you.
thank you. What can I say? We're going to try something totally different than we had originally planned to do, so let's see what's happened with this. Made us feel at home, and we want to thank you for it, so we're going to do another Georgia type tune. This thing is called Catherine. You can help us out.
These gentlemen have had a lot of industry recognition. They've been nominated for Grammys, and up until now, they've always been an instrumental group. They started a few years back when they were all in college, and now they've added vocals, and it's a dynamite sound. Ladies and gentlemen, the Dregs! Wood. I want you to know that I practiced the pronunciation of that, Alex, because I had it wrong. I wanted to say Ligertwood. Do many people do that?
Most people do, yeah.
All right, at least I got it right when I did it on the air.
Thank you.
All right, Steve Morse, would you... I have you perfectly covered with a shadow. I didn't mean to try that. Would you introduce me to your friends, please?
Andy West on bass.
Andy, it's nice to see you, sir. On drums?
Rod Morgenstein.
Nice to have you with us, Rod.
Mark O'Connor, violin
Mark,
and guitar.
Nice to see you, sir. And way over...
T. Lavitz on keyboards.
Why, may I ask, do you guys go out and work 5 months on the road now? Is it because you got a new album? First of all, how came ye with Alex? I mean, this has been an instrumental group. Did he come in and hold a pistol to your head, or did you woo him?
No, he's one of the greatest, as yet, freelance singers that we've ever come across. He's a guest vocalist on the album, and we met up with him through our co-producer, Eddie Offord, who's done Yes and a lot of English bands, and Alex being from across the continent, they knew each other, and we heard tapes that blew us away.
Is it difficult working with what was primarily an instrumental group that they have preconceived notions of what they wanted you to do?
No, it wasn't difficult at all. These guys are...
Tell the truth now, Alex. Tell the truth.
The guys are fantastic. You know, they're very easy to work with.
It's a terrific sound. Let me jump back here for a second, because this group started in college, did I understand?
Right, at University of Miami back in the early 70s.
Why would rock musicians go to college? I mean, I'm using that to entice you into an answer I hope will be profitable here.
It gives you the opportunity to be in among terrific players, and you just cover the spectrum of music that you might not necessarily cover if you're just out in the real world.
There's another question that comes to mind. You're going to go out and spend how many months on the road now?
forever, if we can.
It just seems that way.
It does, really.
How many months will it be?
We usually don't stop until we make the album, and that takes about 3 months every year. But we just tour forever. Yeah.
All right, now, is it profitable in terms of money?
Well, at this stage...
It's planned to be, I know.
Yeah. With the album being out, you end up playing a lot of gigs, not for the money, but for the exposure. And profit is not the bottom line concern.
Andy, how long have you guys been dragging around together?
God, I met Steve in high school back in 1970, so we've been doing it since then. It's been, seems like Mark said, forever.
I wish you very, very good luck. The only man I haven't spoken to, would you like to say hello to anybody at home?
Hi, Mom.
I don't want you to feel like we left you out. This is an instrumental, so I'll take Alex with me to the back room and thrash him properly. What's it called?
Bloodsucking Leeches.
Oh, yes, yes. Ladies and gentlemen, the Dregs! We'll be right back.
right, here's a rock and roll tune for you. This is called Punk Sandwich.